everybody, it's Ron the Meathead Gardener. In today's installment, we're going to look at how I make smoked peppers, also known as chipotles. I've got jalapenos here, kung pao, red habaneros, serranos, Korean green peppers, yellow habaneros, and the hottest of them all, the scorpion pepper, also known as the Trinidad pepper.
What I do is, it's just water. I use about, you know, 2-3 cups. I use a cup of regular white vinegar. I use some sea salt. I throw in a few bay leaves. And then I throw in some peppercorns. You can get pretty elaborate with this, but it's I want the peppers to have the smoky flavor. The little bit of amendments that I put into the water, most notably the vinegar, just gives the peppers that neat little kind of little that little bite. And I found that to be pretty acceptable. So what I do now is I'll just go ahead and heat this up for nothing more than just to kind of jump start the liquid when I put it in the smoker. You don't have to get too elaborate with this, but it's the main thing is to add moisture to the smoking process. You know, you can put fruit juice, you can put you know, soup stock, there's all different kind of herbs and spices you can throw in there. And, you know, being a meathead, I kind of like to keep things simple and just enough to make it work, because after all, the peppers will speak for themselves, but I do want to deliver that smoke and deliver it evenly through each pepper and without drying them out and making them brittle. Nothing does that like this moisture. I've got my pan of vinegar water and the spices. We put that on there. We'll put grill grate number one down. And I'll lay a little bit of tin foil over that to hold the peppers. And the way I clean it, I don't buy one of those fancy scrapers. I just use regular old tin foil, my handy duty tongs. Scrape that bad boy like so. I found the best results for making my chipotles is out of my former not so healthy peach tree, but I don't soak the wood. I just give it a light little wrap in foil that prevents it from flaring up, and that seems to work pretty good. You can see my first stage here. I just snug that right up in here. And those will start smoking in a few minutes. Okay, so I've got the peach wood down. My next layer is a rack full of peppers here. And I have them, I can really stack them, because this the method that I use. They'll all get a nice smoky flavor. Of course, they'll shrink, so there'll be plenty of room in about an hour once they lose their water weight. The gas regulator on my Brinkman it's only on and off, but that's all you need for this method here. You can see I've got my top layer and it's packed full of pounds of peppers. Trust me, this works. So I go ahead and put the lid on it, and check back in about a month and they'll be done. No, just kidding. Just takes a few hours, and we'll do a little inspect here in an hour or so, and we'll give you an update. Now the nice thing about this smoker, I could just grab those handles and pull the unit off the fire. There's a little buddy. That's what they call a skink. Anyway, I can pull that off and add some more wood if need be. It's a pretty foolproof method. So we'll see. I think we got some smoke here. Oh, I can't tell you how good that smells. That peach wood. Wish we had smell-o-vision. Alright, here's what's going on. This has been about an hour and a half. Whoa, yeah. And we got some pepper smoke in here. Now one thing I gotta be careful of is the fire department. Because I've been buzzed a couple times already today by helicopters, and I'm sure they know it's just a smoker, but Florida's known for having wildfires, brush fires, I guess I should say. And anyway, there you have it for now. Let's check on these. It's been about 2 hours. Oh yeah, whoo! Now there's another layer below that. These are all just getting, it's just so rich and just so smoky. And you can see they're starting to get good. Okay, well that took about 4 hours. And this is the end result. Got the jalapenos, the serranos, the kung pao, Korean green, habaneros, and the scorpions. And all in all, they look and smell awesome. You can see the shrinkage. You probably lose about, 60 or 70% through water loss. But from this stage, you can store them in a mason jar, plastic baggie. So I hope you enjoyed that, and happy smoking.